For silver, it's number two.
Within Titanic, the violin song right near the end, which is actually a very popular hymn in church called Nearer My God to Thee. And listening to this song whilst watching Titanic is one of the most saddest things I have ever seen within a movie. And actually, recording this actual clip, at the end of it, it literally got me really crying. You can actually hear me, which I'll let you hear very, very shamefully. Literally, I have a strong heart, but I'm very, very soft. I can fight my battles, but I do cry in other things. I'm afraid I'm a bit of a pussy. Don't blame me. You guys must have something that made you cry. PewDiePie cried in a fucking game, remember? Anyhow, back to this. Titanic was, literally, I can actually say, one of my personal favourite romantic movies slash drama. In this whole scene with the violin, it goes to all the people who are actually going to die in the Titanic itself. The main one that really got me crying was the two old couple in the bed, holding hands and saying goodbye. They're going to sleep together whilst the ship is sinking, which is really, really sad. Then you had the two kids getting told a bedtime story by the mother, and they're in the Titanic ship as well, ready to die. But all the way through it, it gets more and more sadder. This bit in this scene was the most funniest thing I ever seen, was them two guys with the top hats watching the water coming to them, and they're like this.
What the fuck, we're gonna die, motherfuckers.
That was the most funniest bit ever in that sad scene, but everything else got me really cryable. So either way, if you guys think I am complete and utter pussy, I bet you guys, if you've never seen Titanic, you would cry, because it is a really sad film. It's an epic film, but it's very sad. But anyhow, this is my number two spot for Titanic. The violin song, Nearer to My God to Thee.
Fuck, man.
And the number one for gold, it is...
Okay, you guys, I know what you guys are going to be thinking. Really, HBK's retirement is one of the most saddest things for you? Okay, let me explain. HBK, the Heartbreak Kid, Mr. WrestleMania, the Showstopper, Shawn Michaels, is my full-on idol. I loved him when he first began wrestling. Yes, even though before I was born. But when I went to watch wrestling, he was my top favourite wrestler within the WWE. When I found out that he was going to fight The Undertaker again in the next year of WrestleMania 26, I was like, come on, Shawn, you can do this. And then it was for his career. The streak or his career. He went for the streak, he lost. Shawn Michaels had to retire the day later. So within this whole entire speech, I could never watch the speech at all. It took me fucking balls to watch this whole entire scene once again, because it was sad. It made me cry all the way through it. After The Undertaker defeated Shawn Michaels, and after they shook their hands, I was in a bag of tears. After Shawn Michaels lost against The Undertaker, I never spoke for a whole fucking week, because it was that fucking mad. I lost my number one wrestler of all WWE. And after that, I never watched WWE ever again. That's right. I might watch it a fair few times, but that's it. After Shawn Michaels left, it fucked WWE up the ass, because it was fucking shit. Now I'm in TNA. Lol. Anyhow, Shawn Michaels' speech was really one of the most effective ones to me, because he was talking about his respect to The Undertaker. He thanked everybody that he would never thank in his life. He thanked Bret Hart, he thanked Vince McMahon, and even thanked Triple H. But throughout this whole entire scene, people were chanting to him one more match, but he said these words. He doesn't want to turn back and disrespect The Undertaker or anybody else. He gave his word. He will put up his career on the line to beat The Undertaker, which he didn't, so he'll never have a match again.
At 23, I started coming in to each and every one of your homes every week. And the idea of now being 44 and, I don't know, not coming into your homes on that TV set every week is going to be, it's going to be a little tough to get used to.
This scene now is one of the most fantastic scenes I saw when Shawn Michaels heard this music. The music to The Undertaker, I thought to myself, Undertaker, don't you fucking dare go and spoil Shawn Michaels' moment. This is his moment, leave him alone. And when this happened, I burst into tears because I couldn't believe what he did.
Throughout this, just to say, that Undertaker scene, when he came out and tipped his hat, was so perfect. Literally, when he did that, I was like, I cannot believe it. Undertaker gave so much respect to him. I thought after he shook his hand at WrestleMania, and that would have been it, and just rub it in his face. But no, Undertaker was that of a person. He will miss Shawn Michaels, and literally, it still remembers to me this very day when he was in the match. Undertaker did not want to defeat Shawn Michaels. He wanted to lose the match and keep Shawn Michaels in, but Shawn Michaels refused and attacked him instead and made him lose. But anyhow, this whole entire scene at the end of this video, it got me crying, and you'll hear it instantly because it was really that bad. The reason why, because of the D-Generation X symbol. Anyhow, you guys, this is my top saddest moments within TV, gaming, and in filming. Shawn Michaels' retirement was the biggest, because it was that sad. If you guys think differently, please tell me in your comments. We'll see you guys next time. Cheerio.
My farewell speech, and I'll say what I want to say. But there is absolutely no way I can work for anybody else. After you have worked under that crazy son of a gun for 20 plus years, there's no way I'll be able to do a regular gig ever again. Thank him for his patience with me, because the only guy I drove more crazy than Bret Hart was Vince McMahon. You know, and I know that he gave me the opportunity here to do what I love to do. But I have to tell you, I've got to thank him for not allowing me to make even bigger mistakes that I made. I was on a crash course going nowhere, and I know sometimes it was ugly, but I tell you, if that guy had not kept me on course, I would not be here.
support is for everything that I'm doing. Why did you? Why did you?